My dearly beloved in Christ, this feast of Christ the King is relatively new or recent in the long history of Holy Mother Church. It was instituted in 1925 during the Holy Year by Pope Pius XI for the purpose of emphasizing the kingship of Christ in a world that wants to exclude him. Now, if we could think back, those that have studied history, and even just imagine what life would have been like when Europe was Catholic, before the Protestant Reformation, when there would be public processions on the Feast of Corpus Christi through the cities, through the streets of the city, there would be statues of our Lord, our Blessed Mother, in public places. And still to this day, you can go to different countries in Europe, especially in the countryside, and see a crucifixion scene or a statue, a beautiful reminder of how at one time, Catholicism was not just practiced in the home and in the church, but in society. Today, however, we live in a very different time. Since the Protestant Reformation, the attitude has been, in society, you may have your faith, but don't promote it publicly. Practice it in your home if you wish, in your church, but keep it there. We live in a very secular society that would like us to keep our faith, as our Lord said, you don't light a lamp and put it under a bushel, but upon a lampstand. But they would like to keep us to keep it, to keep that light under the bushel, to hidden away. And it is wonderful to see so many Catholic homes where you see outside the home a statue of our Blessed Mother. A reminder, this is a Catholic home. Another thought in regard to this public profession of our faith is that the enthronement of the Sacred Heart in the home, which was begun by Father Mateo, something we've spoken of often, he says in the book on the enthronement that those who want to have their home enthroned to the Sacred Heart, they have a picture or a statue of the Sacred Heart to place in the home, that it must be in a public room of the home. In other words, when guests come, what room do they enter? They should be able to see that image of the Sacred Heart, which is a profession of faith on the part of those who live there, that Jesus is the King of our home. He is the King of our hearts, the King of our home. We are Catholics. So as Father Mateo says, you can't have the enthronement and have the picture enthroned in a room back, a bedroom in the back of the house, but rather again in the main room where guests will see it. So we should not be ashamed of our Lord. We should not be afraid of our faith. It reminds me of those words of our Lord. He that is ashamed of me before men, of him I will be ashamed before my Father in heaven. But if we profess our faith, then our Lord will stand up, so to speak, for us before his Father. This is one of my own. This is one of my loyal followers. So, as I said, beginning with the Protestant Reformation, there has been an effort to secularize society, to eliminate any public acknowledgement of Jesus Christ the King. And especially we see this brought about in France through the terrible revolution of 1789, the Freemasonic Revolution in France, and then similar things taking place in other countries. Now, in the 1800s, there was a great man who became president of Ecuador, South America. And Gabriel Garcia Moreno was elected in around 1870 or thereabouts, and he decided to publicly consecrate his country to the Sacred Heart. And he had a special picture painted for that purpose. The consecration was done in 1873, And the picture of the Sacred Heart had our Lord as king, with a scepter in one hand and holding the globe of the world in the other hand, and his Sacred Heart on the picture. And that picture was placed in the Parliament building. Well, then, of course, the enemies of God, the enemies of the church, were not happy, to say the least. And they plotted his assassination. And that finally was done after he came out of the church on First Friday of the month of August in 1875 and was walking across the square from the church to the Parliament building. He was attacked by Freemasons. He was assassinated. But his last words before he expired were, "God does not die." Now, what happened to the picture that he had painted and that was put in the Parliament building? There were efforts made twice to destroy the picture, but it was rescued. And finally, members of his family hid it away, and they gave it to a priest from Chile who happened to be visiting the country, and he was a member of the Congregation of the Sacred Hearts. Now, the Congregation of the Sacred Hearts of Jesus and Mary was founded in France shortly after the French Revolution. The famous Father Damien of Molokai was a member of that religious congregation. So they sent missionaries out, including to South America. And this is the order that the young priest, Father Mateo, entered around 1900. He was ordained right around early 1900s. And this zealous priest who loved the Sacred Heart and wanted to promote the public reign of Christ the King, of the Sacred Heart in society, thought that the best way he could do that would be to start a Catholic college and educate men to become lawyers, professionals, so that then they in society, as strong Catholics, would promote the reign of Christ the King. But shortly after that college was built, it was completely reduced to rubble by a terrible earthquake in the day after the Assumption in 1906. And Father Mateo wasn't discouraged. He thought, well, I'll start over again, raising money, rebuilding the college. And one interesting thing that I forgot to mention is that a couple years before, he had been working for the provincial in Santiago, Chile, helping him organize his files, and he came across this painting. The canvas was rolled up, but it was that painting that had been commissioned by Gabriel Moreno in Ecuador for the dedication of that country to the Sacred Heart. And Father Mateo went to his superior and asked if he could have the picture. And the superior said, "Yes, if you have it framed and give it a place of honor, you may have it. But it's always to remain in the possession of our religious congregation." So he did that, and that was hanging in a hall of his college. And when the earthquake came and reduced the buildings again to rubble, that picture was untouched. But it was covered in dust. So it was cleaned, given another place, and the picture again shows Christ as king. Eventually, I believe it was returned to Ecuador. But Father Mateo then, because of all that he had gone through, his health was completely depleted, and the doctors told his superior, "You just need to get him away. He is so taken up with his mission, promoting the Sacred Heart, etc. He needs to rest. He needs to recuperate." So the superior sent him to Europe. Well, that fulfilled a long-held dream to visit the chapel where our Lord appeared to St. Margaret Mary in Paray-le-Monial. And while he was kneeling there, he felt himself completely cured. And he also conceived the idea of having families enthrone their homes to the Sacred Heart. And he went for the next few decades all over Europe. Then he went to the Far East. He came to the United States and to Canada. He died, I believe, in 1961. But he spread devotion to the Sacred Heart. And his preaching was so successful that in various village squares, city squares in Europe, there are statues to the Sacred Heart erected publicly to show that this city consecrated itself to the Sacred Heart. And one interesting one is a very large statue that was erected in Spain, and the bishops of Spain consecrated their country to the Sacred Heart, and the statue was erected at the geographic center of Spain, a little bit south of Madrid, a place called El Cerro de los Ángeles. And the statue was something like 90 feet high. Now, some years later, after that was done, there was a terrible communist civil war in Spain in 1936, and the communists destroyed that statue, which showed their true colors, hatred of Christ the King. Well, after the war was over, the people in Spain rebuilt that shrine. They erected another statue to Christ the King at the same place and reconsecrated the country to the Sacred Heart. So the point here is that when Pope Pius XI established this feast in 1925, the purpose of it is to promote the social reign of Christ the King. It's not enough for us to have that love of our Lord in our hearts and to have His Sacred Heart in our home and honor Him in our home. We pray for and we desire the time to come when Jesus Christ will be acknowledged in society, when laws will be written that are based upon the Ten Commandments, the law of God, that the natural law will be reflected in the civil laws in society. And that's something we ought to pray for and to desire, and not to be ashamed of our faith. We spread our faith and we promote our faith by the way that we live. And when others see in us honesty, integrity, to use the word that's often used nowadays, integrity, honesty, fidelity to the civil law and so forth, and of course, avoidance of anything that is offensive to God, people see that. And when they see that, that reminds them how they should live. So we teach by good example, but let us not hesitate when the opportunity comes to explain our faith to others, to be apostles for the Sacred Heart, of spreading love of Him in the world, and to pray again, to pray daily for that time to come when the universal reign of Christ the King will be publicly acknowledged in society. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, amen.